Hey, what's going on? I'm Danny Worsnop.
Hey, and I'm Jeff George, and we are Harlot. What the hell's going on?
What brings you to Aftershock?
We're playing a good old rock and roll concert tomorrow.
Yeah, is that right?
Mainstage, yeah. 1 o'clock. I guess we're going to bring the rock.
We are.
Man, what can we look forward to?
Rock and roll rather than all this angry bullshit.
Some real singing, real playing?
Yeah, we've got no tracks,
no in-ears, nothing. Just real rock and roll band that takes the stage and
guitar
plays.
Guitar solos, songs about pussy. It's good. Yeah.
Beautiful.
It's good stuff.
They're coming right off of Mayhem. How was that?
That was fun. It was a good time, really warm. So everyone's like, it's going to be so hot this weekend. Yeah, everyone's like, it's going to be so hot this weekend. I was like, I've been doing this shit all fucking summer. This is nice and refreshing right now.
It's nice to move up that main stage.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's beautiful. Tell us how this project came together.
Just wanted to make some great rock and roll music with my brothers. This is actually going to be our fourth show.
Is that right?
So already hitting the main stage.
And our first show was Rock in the Rain, main stage.
Yeah.
And 60,000 people for our first show. Our second show was Main Stage Rocklahoma, 45,000 people. So we figured we'd just start out.
So we're already going down. It's already downhill.
Yeah. And what are they expecting out here? I think 50 this weekend or something.
Ooh.
Like that.
So.
When you bring it down to the club level, what's that going to be like when you bring it to the intimate level after all that?
We're just gonna do arenas and stadiums. they can just not sell out. But there were like 200 people.
Yeah, 2015, we hit the world. We toured worldwide starting in January. So we'll have some singles and the record coming very, very soon. Very soon.
Right.
And
then Gene Simmons says rock is dead. What do you got to say?
Fuck Gene Simmons.
I think Gene.
Does he need to retire or what?
Yeah, he needs to shut up.
Kiss is my favorite band of all time. So it's the reason why I started playing music. But I think, you know, he was thinking more of the music business is dead, which is very much correct. I think a lot of the fans and people think that us musicians are millionaires and make tons of money. It's very difficult now. It's tough, man. So I think he was a little bit misquoted, but obviously he likes to talk and loves bad or good press. But rock is not dead. And if you look out there, you're going to see 50,000 kids that it's in every one of their eyes and grown-ups and all these people. And people pay hard-earned money to come out to these things, and that wouldn't happen if rock was dead.
Yeah.
You know, there are other bands in the world besides Kiss. I mean, try telling rock is dead to the Foo Fighters and people like that, you know? I mean, rock is not dead.
Yeah, they sold out Wembley.
Yeah.
Yeah, one chapter closes, another one opens.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And it's more independent, more entrepreneurial. You go out there and you do your thing.
Yeah, I mean, all the music that we write and play is from our influences, which come from Van Halen and Aerosmith and bands like that. So that was, you know, 10, 15, 20 years ago for different people, you know, that we listened to that music. And now we're just regurgitating out in the way that we feel it and see it. So to go up on stage and play those songs, it's like we're listening to our favorite music because that's how these songs have come out. You know what I mean?
Sure.
So, you know, rock is far from dead.
Yeah.
It still lives and breathes in us and the rest of the people here.
We're here to remind everyone.
Yeah, it's not like this is a rap festival. Here it goes, right?
Yeah,
and it gets bigger and bigger every year.
There's not a book club out here.
Exactly.
Now,
what's the biggest difference between the American audiences and the UK or the European audiences?
There really isn't one like that's in a big way. I mean, there are subtle differences in around Europe.
I think sometimes on those festivals, you know, like you play like Wacken or something like that, they don't get to see as much as the U.S. people
do.
Like, we're on YouTube and TV and videos all the time, and it's really accessible. I think when you go over there, some of those people have
waited three or four
years to be able to see their favorite bands one time. So that's when you get a little bit more of a wildness that I think really comes through.
South America is very much like that.
Oh, Brazil is unbelievable.
It's so, I hate to use oversaturated, but kind of is, in America where everyone's spoiled. Everyone's spoiled. Everyone has all the time in the world to see anyone they want because they're going to be there every 4 months.